Do you recognize this sound? Maybe you do, maybe you don't. But if you listen to K-pop, you've probably heard it whether you know it or not. You may be wondering, why is this exact sound in so many songs and where does it come from? In this video, I will be telling you all about these sounds called samples and showing you samples I've saved over the past few months from songs you didn't even know had samples in them. This video is my 1000 subscriber special, so I hope you like this idea and thank you if you have been subscribed to me and watch my videos. Now let's start.
I think many music fans have a bit of confusion when it comes down to what a sample is and is not. I've seen quite a few people be unsure if it's legal or if it's plagiarism when songs use the exact same sounds as each other. So I think it's good to first break down what samples are. Sampling happens anytime you take a sound recording from another source and directly incorporate it into a new song. These sound recordings can be from another song, a movie.
Surely you can see that you could never make her happy.
A voice recording.
Enough is enough. I'm 2 blocks away. I'm coming over.
Or any other audio file you can think of. Now we can divide samples into two groups, samples that require a royalty and royalty-free samples. Samples that require a royalty are sounds you don't own the copyright of and need the explicit permission of the copyright holder to use. In exchange for using a sample, you have to pay the creator an ongoing fee, called a royalty, as well as give them credit in the notes of the songs. However, royalty-free samples work a bit differently. With a royalty-free sample, the copyright owner of the sound allows you to use the sample without paying royalty fees and without giving credit. These are the kinds of samples I will be showing you in this video. You won't find the creators of the sounds I show credited in the writing or production of these songs because they don't require credit to be used. So no, using a sample is not stealing or plagiarism. Given that you follow the rules of the license regarding the type of sample you use. Now let's come back to our sample from the start of the video. This drum fill is a royalty-free sample from a website called Splice and is part of a sample pack called Bad Royale. And as you heard, it has become a very popular sample in K-pop. To understand why it's so popular, you need to understand what Splice is. Splice is a massive royalty-free sound library where you can download samples, and many producers such as Teddy, Monetary and Galactica have been found to use this site to get samples for their productions. This sample has been used so many times since it's from a site that almost every K-pop producer uses. So all these producers have access to this sound, and also it's just a catchy sound in general. And it's not the only Splice sample that has been used in multiple songs. Listen to this other drum fill, for example. Or take a listen to this vocal chop. Mm.
원하는 캐스팅 미안한
Now that you are familiar with how samples work, let's hear some more examples of how they can be incorporated into songs. While researching this video, I was definitely surprised by how many songs had samples in them that I didn't even know about, so here are some of my favorites.
Yeah.
Finally, I want to touch on the reasons why samples are used in the first place. You may have thought that the producers of your favorite songs made it all from scratch, but in reality they actually sampled some parts. So why isn't everything made by the producer themselves?
Well, as an amateur producer, I think it comes down to three reasons.
First, sampling can be more convenient. If you have limited time and resources, it is more convenient to sample a sound than it is to make it yourself. For example, if you want a string section in your song, it is cheaper and takes less time to download a sample than it is to hire a session musician or an orchestra. The second reason is that samples are high quality. You may want to include a certain type of sound in your song, but you may not be that good at making it yourself. In these cases, you can use a sample to make your song sound more professional and polished.
For example, you may play guitar but are not that skilled at it. You can sample a guitar sound from someone who is skilled at playing guitar so your song can sound better.
The last reason is that samples can provide inspiration. You may be stuck and are unsure what to put in your song or where to even start. Using a sample loop can give you a starting point and something to work off of. You then are inspired by that sample and finish the song, whereas before you were stuck and uninspired. I hope through this video you were able to know about samples and maybe learn something new. If you want the link to any of the samples in this video, I have provided them in the description, and maybe you could sample them in a song of your own. Thank you for watching my 1000 subscriber special, and I'll see you next time.